All right, everyone, let's consider a simple part with some datum features specified. Here in this drawing, you can see that the most crucial surfaces of this part, the most crucial aspects of this part, are the leftmost surface, denoted by datum feature A, the bottommost surface, denoted by datum feature B, and the 2-inch width, denoted by datum feature C. Okay, we see these datum feature symbols on the drawing. They're connected to extension lines leading to the respective surfaces. And in the case of datum feature C, it's connected to the dimension line, denoting the width of that dimension. So we know what the most crucial surfaces are in this part. This part is going to assemble, contacting that leftmost surface, contacting that bottommost surface, and then being centered somehow. So considering that, we have the question, how can we best simulate final assembly in manufacturing and measurement, and how can we base all the other features, all the other surfaces, as denoted and labeled on the drawing, how can we base those other surfaces off of the most crucial surfaces, A, datum feature A, datum feature B, and then the mid-plane C? How can we do that? It might seem simple. Well, just machine from those surfaces. Machine from datum feature A and datum feature C when you are making those other surfaces. And then just measure from those surfaces. Measure from datum feature A, measure from datum feature B. That seems pretty simple enough, right? Datum feature A and datum feature B, they look pretty good, right? They look like straight surfaces, straight lines. We should get some good measurement, some good manufacturing of the other surfaces from going based off the most crucial surfaces. That's what makes sense, right? But let's look at datum feature A and B on a microscopic level. These surfaces are actually imperfect, right? They lead to inconsistent results because they're curvy, they got indents, they may even have cracks or nooks, right? They're unlevel. Measuring from this kind of surface, it's going to lead to inconsistent results. And another problem that we have is that just measuring from that surface, we're not really simulating final assembly. Let me try and illustrate this. If we were to put this part into assembly, we would see that the imperfect surfaces of datum feature A and datum feature B, they're contacting on their high points of those crucial surfaces. They're contacting on the high points, right? So if we were to just measure from these surfaces, we're not really going to simulate assembly well. How we can simulate assembly in our manufacturing and in our measurement is actually doing the manufacturing from the geometry that's created from the high points of these most crucial surfaces, datum feature A and datum feature B. How we can simulate final assembly in measurement is that we measure from that plane that is created by the high points of these surfaces. That's what we can do it. That's how we can do it. Because at those high points, that's where contact is happening, right? If we were to measure from that point, we're measuring those features, those other surfaces, as if this part was assembled, right? We're doing it as if it was assembled. So what are these theoretical geometry called? What are these planes called that contact the high points? These geometry that connect the high points, that simulate this final assembly of parts and part features and features of size, those are called datums. That's what the datums are. It's that theoretical geometry that we can't see. It doesn't actually exist. It's something theoretical that we use to get accurate measurements from the most crucial surfaces and to simulate final assembly, to simulate those surfaces in final assembly.